Willis Junior High School Jazz Band. Now we ask you to please rise for the presentation of colors by the Chandler High School Air Force Junior ROTC and remain standing while the Santan Junior High Choir sings our national anthem. The Chandler High ROTC is under the direction of Gary Jones and Scott Goodson, and what talented vocalists we have at Santan Junior High under the direction of choir teacher Wendy Umbriana. To all the elementary students in attendance, interested in music, ROTC, saw the jazz band, choral, got a lot of great options for you when you get to junior high school. Thank you all for being with us. I'm Terry Locke, and I want to welcome everyone to the District Night of Recognition. This is a special night for us. A lot of times on Wednesdays, we have school board meetings. They're kind of mundane, and we don't have nearly the crowd we do tonight. And this is one of those nights we look forward to as the Governing Board Administration to recognizing some of the great people that we have in our schools. Assisting us tonight will be the Governing Board, and it's my pleasure to introduce them at this time on stage, President Annette Auxerre. Vice President Barb Mosden. David Evans. Karen McGee. And Bob Rice. What a tremendous board we have. And of course, our superintendent, Dr. Camille Casteel. These folks represent the great leadership team at Chandler Unified, and Camille herself has 45 years of experience beginning in first grade classroom with us and 20 years as superintendent. So this is the leadership of our school district. I'd like to ask our board president, Ed Auxerre, to share a couple of words.
Did Mr. Locke just say we were old? I wanted you to know that between the five of us, we have about 58 years of experience being on the school board here in Chandler. And we also have 14 great kids who have graduated from Chandler schools and gone on to do great things, just like your kids are going to do. What a tremendous thing that is. We, about in 2010, we started off on an ambitious, rigorous road called Journey 2020. Maybe some of you have heard of it. And it is our way to continually improve our programs to the point where all of your children will have the chance to have the best education available. And our goal was to be the very best district in the state of Arizona. And by many measures, you've heard that, that we have been named that. But next, our next goal, Dr. Casteel says we never let her rest. Our next goal is the best district in the United States. It's lofty, but we can do it. But what I really wanted to do was to thank you for your part. When we have students who are achieving, not just in the classroom, but achieving, growing socially and emotionally and morally, what a great thing that is. When we have teachers working their hearts out and volunteers that do everything they can do to make the classroom a number one classroom, we thank you so much. Give yourselves a round of applause.
Thank you, Mrs. Uxier. Let's get started, shall we? We'll begin with a student recognition. And here's how the format's going to work tonight. We're going to line up all the students. It looks like a really big program. We'll get through it in about an hour, believe it or not. So we encourage you to stay for the whole night. We're going to have all the students come over. Kimberly, wave your hand. We're going to line you up alphabetically by school. So we'll be starting off with Anderson Elementary, Uxier. They're going to line you up. We're going to bring you on the stage, present your recognition tonight, and then you'll exit right here. With the students, we want to take your photograph over here on your left and my right, and we're going to display those photos at the district office for about 6 months until the next group of kids come through here. So we kind of like to showcase you all. Also assisting us tonight are assistant superintendents in attendance. We have Frank Narducci, Frank Fletcher, Sandy Cooper, and Lana Berry. And Matt Strong, where's Matt? There you are, Matt, you're hiding from me. I gotta work on my peripheral vision, don't I? All right, let's begin. If Jillian LaFlamme from Anderson Elementary is here, come on up. Jillian is one of the most genuine, kind-hearted students. Go ahead and meet the board. Yep. We're all gonna learn from Jillian. She gets to be the guinea pig tonight. Jillian is one of the most genuine, kind-hearted students, always willing to help, whether it's a fellow classmate who's feeling down or not understanding the material, to helping in the cafeteria by serving food when they are shorthanded, to all the many ways she's there to help and support her teachers, who say they don't think it's possible for this amazing, bright student to ever have a bad day at school. Congratulations. Macy Merrill from Uxier Elementary. Now, Macy is a leader inside and out of the classroom. When in class, Macy doesn't hesitate to step up and help her teacher or classmates. She truly uses the seven habits by thinking win-win in tough situations. She's respectful, responsible, loyal, and trustworthy. She does anything and everything that is asked of her with a smile on her face, from helping a new student adjust to a new school or working on an assigned project that is out of her comfort zone. Aiden Felix from Basha Elementary. Now, Aiden is actively involved in Basha's Media Club, along with the Basha Choir. He has also played in the school band for the past 2 years, and he was this year's spelling bee champion for the school, and gives his best academically. Most of all, he's kind to everyone he meets, and a pleasure to have at school. Aiden can be counted on to be professional on camera, but also adds a dose of his personality when needed to liven up the announcements. McKenna Schrader from Bologna Elementary. Throughout the year, McKenna has shown compassion for others through her participation in Junior Buddies, a club that promotes friendships and inclusive opportunities with students who have special needs. She has shown maturity and is now a focused, determined, confident individual. She has set high goals for herself and is working diligently to meet those goals. McKenna is the Student Council Vice President and works hard to represent the student body. Faith Peterson from Carlson Elementary. Now, Faith is currently serving as Student Council President. Faith is an amazing kid with spectacular character. As a student, Faith is organized, responsible, and a great class role model. Equally as impressive has been her approach to being president. Under her leadership and with commitment to the school, Student Council is having one of the most amazing and productive years ever. Congratulations, Faith. I want to tell the kids, too, we've framed your certificates tonight, but if you want to take the frame off and look, what I'm talking about the students tonight, you can actually read that paragraph on the back of the certificate later. Okay, next is Tegan Sanders from Conley Elementary. Now in sixth grade, Tegan has been at Conley since kindergarten, and teachers will tell you that she's just an awesome person and student. This year, Tegan has served as Student Council President. She leads with a rare level of sophistication for a sixth grader. Tegan dives into every student council activity, be it a fundraiser or an assembly to honor veterans, with confident determination and a can-do attitude. Miles Fossen from CTA Freedom. Miles challenges himself to do the best that he can and holds himself to the highest standards. Not only is Miles a phenomenal student, he's also involved in extracurricular activities. Miles is a state champion when it comes to playing the piano, too. He has even played at Carnegie Hall. Miles is also on the CTA Freedom Orchestra and Freedom Basketball Team for 5th and 6th grade. He does it all, doesn't he? Dia Surratt from CTA Goodman. Dia has attended CTA Goodman since kindergarten and has left an indelible mark each year along the journey to 6th grade. Dia is polite, honest, and extremely hardworking. Her talents were recognized by her peers this year as she was elected student council president. Dia has been on the honor roll, or principal's roll, every quarter since fourth grade, and whenever the school needs a good speaker for an impromptu reading, Dia can do it. Is there a child who needs escorting to kindergarten? Whatever the case, she's there for that person. Congratulations. Emily Alvarado from CTA Humphrey. Now, Emily works hard in class and always puts forth her best attitude and effort. She perseveres when given a challenge and strives to achieve her goals. When asked to have homework out on her desk, take out a notebook, or any other student teacher directive, she's always the first student to be ready. She has a great disposition and attitude that helping others is a goal she strives to achieve. She's involved with the Running Club, News Club, and the Red Hats at CTA Humphrey. Katarina Roars from CTA Independence. When Katarina walks into the classroom, something changes. Her exuberant personality shines with her greeting of good morning to every teacher she walks by. Her engagement in class is one full of energy and excitement for learning. She's able to think abstractly, allowing for all of her classmates to learn from her whenever she shares her ideas. She completes her classwork with pride and often goes above and beyond the given expectations. Mariana Cantu, CTA Liberty. Mariana Cantu Valenzuela is an extremely hard worker in the sixth grade at CTA Liberty. And despite transferring to the school in the fifth grade, she has persevered and made the honor roll, which is not an easy accomplishment. Mariana is a strong participant in class. She volunteers, answers, and asks questions to clarify her understanding of difficult material. She's an awesome example for her peers, and that she always is kind and respectful to those around her. Cooper Moss from Elite Performance Academy. Cooper has been a great help at initiating school spirit during EPA's inaugural year. I'll tell you more about that school when we're done here. During the school's lip sync competition, she choreographed and taught the third grade's dance. She went above and beyond to help them prepare and perform. And Cooper has the ability to see what is needed and always volunteers to help with what's needed. She brings a level of excitement to each class and is a great motivator to students around her. So she's a great example of one of our students at our newest school, Elite Performance Academy, which houses a little over 100 students and they're all extremely competitively active in various sports like gymnastics and so forth. And we cooperate with the schools in the community, and the kids get their basics from us, and we transport to the schools. It's a new partnership, and it's doing well. And you can see Cooper's a classic example of someone prospering from that system. Congratulations. Jasmine Molinar from Fry Elementary. Now, Jasmine is a shining star. She's a true leader in every sense. Jasmine continually goes above and beyond. She always thinks of others first and looks for opportunities to help students and staff members succeed. Jasmine is a young lady who only sees people's potential and goodness. She's a cheerleader for humanity and thrives on lending a helping hand to anyone in need. Isaac Johnson from Fulton Elementary. Isaac's enthusiasm, contagious energy, and smile bring happiness and a positive attitude to those around him. He is genuinely kind and goes above and beyond to care for others. Isaac is always willing to help his peers and teachers in any way possible. Academically, Isaac consistently puts forth high efforts of effort and works hard across all areas of the curriculum. He devotes many hours to being involved in his church, practicing the drums, and playing sports, including football and basketball. Eduardo Geiner from Galveston Elementary. Now, Eduardo has overcome a very serious medical condition that included being airlifted to Phoenix Children's Hospital, where he underwent extensive brain surgery. He has persevered and then some, displayed model student behavior and ongoing excellence in academics. Citizenship is a term that comes to mind when describing Eduardo because he shows a great desire to do well and to strengthen himself as the best student he could possibly be. He's trustworthy and caring and continually treats each of his peers with respect and dignity. Chloe Thompson from Haley Elementary. Chloe comes to school prepared and ready to give her all and with a positive attitude. She's welcoming and open with her peers, takes on responsibilities willingly, and assists wherever she can. When Chloe takes on a challenge, it will be completed accurately and with quality in mind. And Chloe is active with student council, running club, drama club, and assists after school with Beyond the Bell program. Ben Morrison from Hancock Elementary. Now, Ben is new to the school this year, but he immediately jumped in and became part of that Hancock school family. Ben is not only helpful and respectful to teachers and staff, but has become a real leader at school, making sure that no student is left out. This quarter, he broke his ankle, but that injury didn't cause him to miss one beat. And Ben is passionate about learning and brings tons of positive energy to the classroom learning environment. And students and staff both enjoy working with him. Rafael Almanza from Hartford Sylvie Encinas. Rafael is not only an excellent student, but he also is actively involved in many community and school clubs. He does community service for his church. He's an avid soccer player who's a big asset to this team. Rafael also belongs to the Coding Club and the Battle of Books Club and is now seeking membership in the Hartford Sylvie Encinas Yearbook Club. He plays in a mariachi group and sings in the choral group as well. This young man is a member of the K Kids Club. He provides services for the entire community. Rachel Ortiz from Hull Elementary. Rachel is respectful, responsible, and recognizes when someone is in need of a friend and supports her peers, giving compliments willingly and sharing materials with those who need them. She is extraordinarily kind to all people. She does all she can to help and simply be there for others. Rachel also puts forth her best effort in school, and her sense of responsibility shines through on a daily basis. Rose Conley from Jacobson Elementary. We're told that Rose is the whole package. She's an excellent sixth grade student at Jacobson who is dedicated to her academics. She also volunteers to help other students in the class who may be struggling with a concept. Rose has been on the student council for 2 years. In fact, she took the office of secretary this year and has played an important role with student council activities. Next is Todd Applegate from Knox Gifted Academy. Todd is very involved in the Knox community and has taken on orchestra, student council, Vex Robotics, and Flag Corps responsibility. He has amazing leadership qualities, including honesty and organization. Todd is always taking pride in his work, puts his best effort, and his sense of responsibility shines through on a daily basis. He's very conscientious of his actions and the people around him. Annie Hartman from Navarette Elementary. Annie is a hardworking student who always puts her best foot forward. She continually strives to do her best. She reaches out to and is willing to help in anyone and all any need they have. As a student council member, she is involved in helping Navarette and the community. Annie is very responsible and a hard worker and a great role model because of her excellent behavior. Eli Zink from Patterson Elementary. Eli epitomizes the character of the ideal student. He comes to class ready to learn and puts effort into doing well in school. Eli demonstrates self-control, is responsible to others in the classroom and to the teachers, and most importantly, when the classroom is otherwise chaotic, this ideal student can be relied on for doing the right thing. In the classroom, when things get crazy, Eli's teacher asks the students to channel their inner Eli. Robert Wilkie from Riggs Elementary. Robert comes to school every day with enthusiasm and a smile. He's always prepared and has a desire to succeed in everything that he does. Robert is very respectful to the students and staff at Riggs and serves as a role model to others. Robert always takes pride in his work and his sense of responsibility shines through on a daily basis. Through quiet leadership, Robert is able to work quite efficiently in group tasks and always shows great effort in all of his work. Kaylia Cole from Ryan Elementary. Kaylia is known for overwhelming acts of kindness and hard work. And for the last 5 years, Kaylia has chosen to spend her birthdays doing service projects, on her birthday even. These include Kaylia's Carnival, where she asked friends to bring gifts for children in an orphanage, rather than for her. She donated these gifts to the East Valley Child Crisis Center. And for other birthdays, she requested dog or cat food for a local pet shelter, clothing, shoes, and household goods to help those in need after the Oklahoma City tornado, and on and on and on. Congratulations. Tate Scott from Zandhorn Elementary. Tate is an ideal student. Tate is an ideal student who perseveres through any task and does so with a smile. He's a responsible student who always completes homework and classroom assignments on time. Tate is also a team player who works well with collaborating with other students and is a person who students and teachers can always count on. Jillian Famabongsa from San Marcos Elementary. Jillian is insightful. She will wait for others in her class to share before coming out with what she knows is the correct answer, or with an alternative solution even. She is incredibly patient with others. She explains concepts well to others who are struggling and finds different ways to explain it until they also understand. She's very compassionate and cares about everyone around her. She gives guidance to others and is the champion for the underdogs. Sage Patzer from Santan Elementary. Sage is a straight-A student and exemplifies a strong work ethic in the CATS classroom at Santan. She's also one that seeks opportunities to serve and always striving to help others, either at school or during her off times. She plays competitive soccer for the Santan Legacy Club and also plays tennis. Sage is a member of the Girl Scouts, and she volunteers her time at her grandmother's retirement home by singing and playing instruments for the retirees. Emma Santa Stephen from Shumway Elementary, Shumway Learning Academy. Shumway has converted to the Shumway Learning Academy, if you didn't know. Emma is a model student and constantly striving at Shumway. She works hard to turn in all of her assignments and gives it her best effort even when the task is challenging. Emma is an outstanding leader at Shumway, spearheading a school beautification project on her own. She found student volunteers to help with a painting leadership on the cafeteria windows after school. And when complimented about the project, she deflected all the credit and just thanked the volunteers. Taylor James from Tarwater Elementary. Taylor is focused in class and always willing to help others. Her patience and true desire to help others shows in the exceptional job she does working with special needs children. Taylor not only excels academically, but is very active in club soccer, a member of the Tarwater Running Club, Random Acts of Kindness Club, and the Chorus Club. She has very high aspirations for her future, as she would one day like to become a neonatal doctor one day. Very impressive. Ethan Anderson from Weinberg Elementary. Among his fellow classmates, Ethan is ever on task, diligently completing all of his assignments, and refuses to participate in off-task behavior. Among the younger students on campus, Ethan serves as a buddy to a first-grade student. He organizes events as a member of the student council and always has a positive attitude. He's able to actively participate during class, and his demeanor is such that it encourages others around him to become more actively engaged as well. Next are the junior high schools, starting with Jasmine Montez Williams from Anderson Junior High. Jasmine is an incredible student. She's in the choir and orchestra, takes honors math and language arts, and is in student council and National Junior Honor Society. Her teachers report that Jasmine is a self-starter with outstanding leadership skills. She's always the first to volunteer to be involved in school projects and tasks. And when Jasmine is working with a group of students, you know the end result will be excellent. Tyler Cranston from Bogle Junior High. Tyler's commitment to academics and athletics, as well as his notable compassion and kindness to others, truly makes him a leader among students. Most notably, Tyler volunteered in early September to take on additional duties in order to support a new teammate. He single-handedly assisted a student in a wheelchair to and from classes. And in the classroom, Tyler is no nonsense. He comes to class ready to learn and helps those around him whenever they are in need of academic assistance. Amanda Rowley from Payne Junior High. Amanda is the president for Panther Pals and is also a student aide in class. She is an amazing young lady. Amanda has an inspiring and empowering impact among her peers and all the students within Panther Pals. She is also a positive advocate for students with an intellectual disability. Amanda is a natural nurturer. She's thoughtful, kind, and always very positive. Libby Armbruster from Santan Junior High. Libby never allows circumstances to conflict with her responsibilities as a student, both in and out of the classroom. One would have to view the high standard of her academic work firsthand to fully appreciate the effort and expertise in which she applies to her studies. However, the most colossal of her achievements this year is not bound to one singular event. It's her ongoing and without failing altruistic approach to her peers. Whereas some students may shun the opportunity to assist the peer who is in need, whether that be academically or through a hand of friendship being extended, Libby will embrace that person each and every time. John Coolidge from Willis Junior High. Yeah! His time at Willis, John has grown a great deal academically and socially, and is admired by his classmates and staff members. In addition to being worthy of recognition for his personal accomplishments, John has gone out of his way to demonstrate kindness to a number of special education students at Willis. There is one student in particular who John has befriended, providing consistent support and encouragement. This student lights up when John is around, and we sure appreciate that. John? Next are some of our alternative campuses. Our Arizona College Prep Erie campus serves 7 through 12, and we have Casey Blue with us. Casey is the first one to volunteer to help her fellow classmates and teachers, and she's a natural leader inside and out of the class, leading by example. Casey has also greatly enriched the school's culture by engaging in extracurricular activities. She has participated in a wide variety of clubs and sports, including student council, student government, treasurer, fellowship of Christian athletes, robotics club, mentor club, and varsity club. So it's a college prep program with all of the great specials at the campus, and we're glad to see Casey taking advantage of those. Aria Luca from Arizona College Prep Oakland campus. This campus serves grades 6-8, and it's also a partner with the Erie campus that we just recognized. Aria is a wonderful example of what strive for the impossible and be extraordinary looks like. She is a driven, hardworking, and responsible student. She's also a great role model for her peers inside and out of the classroom. She's eager to include others in her activities and friendly to all. She is quick to pass on a smile and lend a helping hand where she's needed. Natalie Edwards from Basha Accelerated Middle School. Now, Basha Accelerated Middle School is a 6th, 7th, and 8th grade concept on the Basha High campus. And those kids take advantage of AP teachers, for example, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. So you've got a lot of great choices in Chandler Unified, as you see. Natalie has shown tremendous growth and served as a role model at Basha Accelerated Middle School. She's an active leader on student council, a member of the running club, and has served with her family in the Philippines. She has a big heart, always welcoming new students, showing respect to her teachers, and working hard to be the best that she can be. Chandler Early College is next. This is located on the Chandler Gilbert Community College, where students earn dual credits right there on campus. We have Diana Nguyen from Chandler Early College. Diane exemplifies the true spirit of Chandler Early College. She's friendly, responsible, and dedicated to her academic success. She works hard in both her high school and college classes, and no matter how difficult the workload, she has a ready smile and greeting for all those she meets. She truly stands out among her peers. Abigail Larson from Chandler Online Academy. These students are able to juggle a lot of things in their life, and Chandler Online meets that need, and these kids are just prospering so well. And Abby's been a student since 9th grade, and her work is done on time, and the quality of the work is phenomenal. Abby's had some struggles in her life, but has worked tirelessly to overcome these things. Her determination to always do better will continue to benefit her in her life, and her driven attitude has propelled her to become one of the top students at Chandler Online Academy. Bailey Zanetti from Hill Learning Academy. Bailey is an outstanding scholar and always goes above and beyond the mark. She strives to become her best self both academically and personally. She's quick to help those around her, teacher and student alike. And no matter where she goes, she stands out as one of the best and the brightest. Bailey, congratulations. From Basha High School, Kathleen Looney. Kathleen is a student government president in all honors and AP courses and volunteers her community. She does all this with a supportive and positive attitude. She is composed throughout all of her events that she leads or participates. Kathleen is a wonderful role model through her leadership in STUGO as president and as the 50-member DECA Club. Congratulations, Kathleen. Andrew Starks from Casteel High. He's not here today. Tristan Brown from Chandler High School. Tristan has always gone above and beyond with others and made sure he puts his peers, family, and friends first. He has always put his concerns aside to make sure that those around him know they have someone they can count on. Tristan will be there continually, not only with his education, but for his service for others in the military upon graduation. Tristan, we wish you the best. Elliot Smith from Hamilton High School. Elliot's indomitable spirit seems never to waver despite all that she takes on. Rigorous coursework, multiple clubs, extracurricular activities, science projects, and more. Enthusiasm, determination, and confidence are three words that come to mind when we think of how to describe Elliot. Her work in the community reached a zenith for her in high school as a volunteer at the local community hospital with grades and test scores that are off the charts. Congratulations. And finally, Amanda Riley from Perry High School. Amanda is always happy to assist fellow students who need a little extra help, and she works so hard to be great at everything she tries. Amanda befriends those who don't otherwise have many friends. So when a certain student has run the class patience down to zero, she still shows compassion toward that person. She takes honors courses and earns good grades despite having a medical condition that keeps her from attending school as regularly as she would like. She's a member of the Honor Society and selflessly serves her community. How about one more round of applause for all these great students? A little favor to ask, would all the parents, grandparents, siblings of these great kids please stand so we can applaud all of your efforts? Behind every successful student is a supportive family. We appreciate all that you're doing to help these students succeed and for choosing Chandler. Shall we move on to the volunteers? Y'all learn from the kids. They showed us how to line up on your right. We're going to do the same thing with volunteers, alphabetical by school, beginning with Anderson. So without further ado, Kimberly, wave and head to Kimberly. And Rosa Mesa, when you get here, just come straight up on stage. These are volunteers next. Rosa Mesa, come on up stage when you're ready. Here comes Rosa. When Rosa is not working in the cafeteria or at lunch recess, she volunteers helping custodians keep the school looking top-notch. Many times she leaves after lunch and comes back to school after the students have left to help clean the school. Rosa takes pride in everything that she does. She's well-loved by the staff and the students. Kathy Kennedy from Oxier Elementary. Kathy helped start our newest elementary school, got off to a smooth start. She works in the cafeteria as a noon aide, but also volunteers throughout the day, which is why she's being recognized tonight. She's always willing to help and says no job is too small. She's kind to everyone around her and always has a smile on her face. The staff at Oxier appreciate all the time she puts in to making the school amazing. April Sterner from Bologna Elementary. April consistently comes in for copy lessons for teachers in her granddaughter's class, as well as any other teachers on campus that need the assistance. She arrives at school with a smile and willing to do anything asked of her. April is organized and brings material back to the teachers in place and ready for student distribution. She has a positive attitude with the students and is always extremely reliable. Sheila Galante from Carlson Elementary. Sheila's ideas and creativity have families making special trips down the hallways to see her amazing artwork. She makes the school festive and gives it an amazing community feel. Her latest display for Veterans Day was gorgeous. The school honored family veterans up and down the main hall, and she headed up the Boobash, which was also a huge success. And families look forward to that event each year. We appreciate it, Sheila. Jeremy Sellers from Conley Elementary. Jeremy is active in school functions, including superintendent advisory group, coffee with the principal, and classroom activities. Jeremy also volunteers every morning as a crossing guard. Conley has had many people from the community call and ask him, who's that really friendly crossing guard? And how do they appreciate his friendly smile and wave as they pass by? Thank you, Jeremy. Stacy Hawk from CTA Freedom. Stacy volunteers freely of her time and resources regularly at Freedom. On any given day, you'll find her at the school helping in some capacity. While she spends most of her time assisting the lower primary grades, Stacy also puts in many hours working with the school PTO in different capacities. She is known to be a volunteer who puts students first and always has the best interest in mind. Tammy Messerall from CTA Goodman. For the past several years, Tammy has been an active member of the PTO and volunteer at CTA Goodman. Where there's a need for a volunteer, Tammy has been there. She helps in the classroom and at school-wide events such as book fair, fun run, volleyball, sock hop, Western Week, and fall festivals, just to name a few. Christina Green from CTA Humphrey. Christina is an exceptional art masterpiece coordinator. She works tirelessly to organize the lessons, supplies, stock prints, and just make sure the program is going great. She puts in countless hours both at the school and at home, and volunteers who have taught the lessons for years have commented how well it is run compared to the way it could be. Joelle Watson from CTA Independence. Joelle currently serves as the fundraising chair for the CTA Independence PTO. This past semester, Joelle coordinated the first ever Independence Fun Run without the use of an outside company. In years past, the site and many schools have used outside companies to organize a fun run as it brought in great results, but it increased the revenue funding. She really coordinated the entire event and planned it, organized, and designed the interactive fundraiser and the obstacle course. And we appreciate all your work. Melissa Douglas from CTA Liberty Campus. Melissa works tirelessly as a member of the PTA board and donates her time to the library, working on a regular basis to keep the library open to all students. The amount of time she selflessly donates to the school exceeds all expectations. She's an asset to CTA Liberty because she's dependable, pleasant, and trustworthy. Sarah Goodman from the Elite Performance Academy. Sarah has been an outstanding volunteer, very visible on campus, and attends school activities and has volunteered to be a chaperone for all the school field trips. Not only is she a present member on campus, but she uses her photography skills to capture important moments in the school's short history. From dancing teachers to inquisitive students, she has caught it all on camera. Maria Mendina from Fry Elementary. Now, Maria donates her personal time to help teachers prepare materials for their students. She volunteers for field trips, art masterpiece, and the running club. She has been volunteering at Fry for many years, and she's a very caring and nurturing individual, and you can see why Fry students and staff all love her. Shira Williams from Fulton Elementary is not here. Linda Scharf from Galveston Elementary. Although she has no children at Galveston, Linda, a retired accountant, has volunteered for more than 2 years. She reads with kids and helps individuals with projects. She supports kids with their thinner work and is happy to dig in with any project given, including having multiple kids read the same story to her. She's cheerful and patient and really a blessing to the students. The tag team of Davianne Fife and Crystal Wells from Haley Elementary. They both volunteer in multiple classrooms. They prep materials in the workroom as well as help supervise the parking lot whenever it's starting to get a little out of hand. We can all appreciate that. They organize the bingo night, which is always a huge success due to their high energy and commitment. Both contribute greatly to helping make Haley a better place. Sylvia Mullen from Hancock Elementary. Sylvia puts in countless hours serving students and staff and is determined to make Hancock a wonderful place to be. Her kind and servant heart is noticed by everyone she encounters. As co-president of Hancock's PTO, Sylvia plans and implements a variety of PTO activities for the Hancock families. Graciela Almanza from Hartford Sylvian Sinus Elementary. Graciela is the PTO board member and spends a lot of time at the Hartford Sylvian Sinus Parent Center. Graciela is willing to help out in any way possible. She's always a visible parent on campus and was a key member of the school's toy drive. She spent countless hours counting, sorting, and packing toys for students. The Hartford Sylvian Sinus staff truly appreciates Graciela for her support at the school. Richard Wallace from Hull Elementary. Richard is PTO president and supports fundraising efforts at Hull, provides students and community with fun events throughout the year. His dedication to the PTO has allowed the school to purchase much-needed resources, including curriculum materials and technology needs. You can see Richard attending every PTO event and supporting various committees. Melanie Yarns from Jacobson Elementary. Melanie puts in countless hours for the Art Masterpiece program at Jacobson. She's such a delight to see in action where she is training other volunteers. Her time and effort for this program don't go unnoticed. The Art Masterpiece program is strong due to efforts of Melanie at Jacobson Elementary. Jen Tobias from Knox Gifted Academy. Jen is the PTO president and has a calmness about her while managing to support all the many events and happenings around the school. When everyone is running around to set up events, she is running next to them. Jen remains calm and is always solutions-oriented. The staff doesn't have to pull their hair out during fundraisers because Jen makes sure everything fits into the busy schedule. We appreciate it, Jen. Kim Richter from Navarette Elementary. Kim regularly helps in the copy room, school library, and three children's classrooms. She's always willing to go the extra mile and help in whatever capacity needed. She manages the accelerated reader word count for the entire school, making sure all the millionaires are recognized and bulletin boards are up to date. Kim works countless hours shelving books and making sure the library is kept organized and efficient. Dewan Katz from Patterson Elementary. Not only does Dwan wake up early to serve the staff amazing breakfast monthly, but her family is also involved and does it with big smiles and cheerful attitudes. She's amazing and is always there to help in the classroom, whether it's behind the scenes making copious amounts of copies or front and center planning and administering parties. Robert Oswald from Riggs Elementary. Robin is known as Grandma O. She's an amazing addition to any classroom with both her education and time spent in the classroom, as well as her experience as a mom and grandma. Grandma O is the best, we hear. She works with the students, shows patience and knowledge, and helps them understand and encourages them at all times. She always has a kind word to say and humors them at times when she senses frustration or trouble understanding. Charlie Hess from Ryan Elementary. Charlie is always willing to go above and beyond, helping out at PTO events, including Jamba Juice, Fall Festival, and many others. He's made sign pole, flag signs, and games for the Fall Festival. He also worked diligently securing audio and sound system donations. Charlie is always positive, personable, and a joy to be around. Mary Ordonez from Sanborn Elementary is not here. Next is Mary Lopez from San Marcos. Is Mary here? Okay, let's move to Julie Klein from Santan Elementary. Julie has been an integral part of the Art Masterpiece program for 5 years now. She and a colleague created the Santan Art Gallery. And each month, she, along with the principal, Amy O'Neill, visit various grade levels and classrooms to identify selected student artists for display in the gallery. She also creates artist profiles to display along with the students' work. And great job at Santan. Rachel Willis from Shumway Learning Academy, Leadership Academy. Rachel is a vital part of that Shumway Leadership Academy. She's been volunteering since her oldest child attended kindergarten, and that child is now graduating from high school. Rachel is a familiar face around campus and at events. However, she has been invaluable in the drama and music departments as well. She writes her own scripts and songs and presents amazing performances every year. Margaret Ann Dunn from Tarwater Elementary. Margaret Ann puts in many hours in children's classrooms, running the book fairs, assisting teachers with workroom duties, decorating the school, classroom performances, assisting in the school office, and volunteering at school functions. Her Scottish accent is a warm and is such a delight for the students and staff to listen to. She always carries a smile and an encouraging attitude. Next, I believe we have the couple, Betty and Neil Peer, right? Are they here? Betty and Neil Peer, yes. I'll tell you about this special couple. For the last 6 years, they've been instrumental in the promotion and recognition of student citizenship and patriotism at Bogle Junior High. As officers in the Sun Lakes VFW post, they work tirelessly to encourage participation in the annual VFW Patriots Pen Essay Contest. And Neil and Betty also help to create Bogle Citizens of the Year Awards. They make history real for students by sharing their experience and stories about their service. Their dedication and support that Betty and Neil have given the school over the years has made an immeasurable impact and is reflective of the powerful role that retirees play in our school district. Wayne Glashagel from Payne Junior High School. Now, Wayne's been a volunteer softball coach at Payne for 5 years. He has dedicated his time to the athletes and has been a vital part of the team's success. He travels more than 30 miles and uses his own money to go into and from each game and practice. He has brought in his own equipment when needed and helps the athletes improve on a particular skill. He's never complained about the time it's taken away from his own family to be there, making Payne softball an even better program. Helena Kowchak from Santan Junior High. Helena has been president and treasurer of the Santan Junior High Parents Booster Organization for the last 2 years. She additionally serves on the CUSD Budget Committee and the Superintendent's Parent Council. Helena has been instrumental in so many positive ways at Santan Junior High. She's been a key player in school-wide initiatives for Chromebooks and computer on wheels carts. Tremendous work at Santan Junior High. Next is Amy Hendrickson from Willis Junior High. Now, some of you are saying, isn't Amy an employee for CUSD? She is, but she's being recognized tonight for her volunteer work at Willis Junior High. This year, Amy stepped up and filled a leadership void by taking on the PTO president position. She's gone out of her way to ensure that this job is done well, taking personal responsibility to get things done. She's a kind and caring person who truly has a servant's heart. Next is Jim Bishop from Arizona College Prep Erie Campus. Some of you may know the name. Jim led the Yes for Chandler students drive last year. You know where we're going with this. To ensure the passage of a bond election with a 2-to-1 vote last November. Jim was the heart and soul of that organization. However, Jim is also being recognized for his volunteer work at Erie. He's an assistant coach for the wrestling team at ACP Erie. He served as a volunteer assistant and always there to lend a helping hand, including wrestling and ACP really as a whole. He's very involved in helping the Booster Club as well. And Jim, we appreciate everything you've done and continue to do. Sue Dean from Arizona College Prep Oakland Campus. Sue goes above and beyond with helping in the copy room. She volunteers weekly and has come in over breaks even to assist teachers in helping them get ahead. Her high standards are apparent in the quality of work that she does. Produce a clear original for making copies. She even lightens up pictures or cuts out blackened areas if needed prior to doing any print job. She's flexible and generous with her time. Has become a real asset for ACP Oakland. April Campbell from Bash's Accelerated Middle School. And this is the school that serves great kids in 6th through 8th grade at the Bash High School campus. They've also got some great activities. And April's being recognized for her work volunteering with the Accelerated Middle School Running Club. She contributes to the students having a positive self-image by motivating and encouraging them to be the best physically and mentally. April, we appreciate it. Eddie Garza from Basha High School. Eddie is a staple volunteer at all band rehearsals. He coordinates other volunteers, drives the Basha High School band truck, he serves food, and is generally available for any band need. He goes above and beyond regularly, and having Eddie handling so many facets of Basha High band results in having a smoother band season. Next, we have the Rock Point Church for Casteel High School. We have any volunteers here tonight? Okay. Next is Sherry Simon from Chandler High School. Sherry is a go-to parent who will drop everything if the school is in need. She serves as the CHS Parent Advisory Council, site counsel, and an officer in the Girls Volleyball Booster Club. In addition, Sherry is a key player in the annual CHS Academic Recognition Day and organizes parent volunteers for a special lunchtime celebration for Chandler High academic scholars. Samita Basur from Hamilton High School. Samita volunteers at least 5 hours every day helping the school social worker with various programs. She's punctual, committed, and passionate, and enjoys helping students. Sam has been running the free food delivery program, including setup and organizing, so it's easy for the students to come and pick up their weekly food bags. She's also been instrumental in coordinating the 40 Thanksgiving dinners that went to Hamilton families in need. We appreciate all you're doing. Tom Casteel from Perry High School. Now, if that last name sounds familiar, our person, our furless, Camille Casteel, this is her husband. Let me tell you about Tom. He's been volunteering for 10 years at Perry High School since the school's inception as a security guard. He continually goes above and beyond the call of duty. He's volunteered as freshman wrestling coach. He has a huge heart for students and continues to be a staple in that F building. He's helped mold Perry into a great place to become for students and staff, even coining the phrase, Perrydice. And finally, Teresa Niemeyer from the Melinda Romero Instructional Resource Center. As a volunteer and community member, Teresa stands out as a true champion for education. Intel's volunteer model is I'm in, and Teresa is an Intel employee who raises her hand for volunteer opportunities throughout her community and beyond to say I'm in. This year, as the district welcomed 2 guest teachers for the Mandarin language programs from China, Teresa volunteered to be a host. Really, that's quite a commitment, didn't it? As these people learn a new country, a new culture, a new life here in Chandler. Teresa, we appreciate it. How about one more round of applause for all of our volunteer winners? Last but not least, by any means, we're going to recognize some of the great staff we have at our sites. And we'll line up right of stage. And then Christy Clemente from Anderson Elementary, when you're ready, come on up. Christy Clemente, come straight to the stage when you're ready. Here's Christy. Christy is not only a great platooning partner, but she's also taken on the sole responsibility of helping teachers administer the new Galileo testing. Additionally, she helps teachers weekly with Infinite Campus and their websites. Christy is great with parent communication, listing homework daily, making phone calls, and sending emails to parents. Carolyn McCleary from Oxier Elementary. Carolyn is one of the key people to get Oxier Elementary off to a great start. As the school's media specialist, she's very skillful, where she set up the whole library and organized and distributed all the curriculum books and materials. She turned the library into a very inviting space for both students and staff, with beautiful decorations as well. Thank you, Carolyn. Julie Tumolino from Basha Elementary, third grade teacher. Julie goes out of her way to promote the school's motto, Pride in the Pack, by providing resources that teachers can use, and by frequently changing bulletin boards in the hallway to reflect the current trait being worked on. She constantly has a positive attitude when interacting with staff and students. Thank you. Next is Beth Hartman from Bologna Elementary. Beth is a math interventionist and takes on the role of demonstrating her dedication to the students by preparing work that is both instructive and engaging. She's always willing to help and create new ideas to ensure students understand their math skills. Not only is Beth great with the students, she's a wonderful addition to the faculty. Kim Schuck from Carlson Elementary. Kim is an amazing teacher, kindergarten teacher. Teaches kindergartners with the utmost kindness and patience. She uses her organizational skills and creativity to initiate improvement in instruction wherever she can. She's an exceptional leader among her colleagues and a social studies cadre representative. She can be counted on to provide an abundance of easily accessible resources and activities. Jessica Benenson from Conley Elementary, special education resource teacher. Even though Jessica has a very full caseload as a special education teacher, she took on the challenge of taking on the leadership role implementing the new Galileo assessment tool. She works tirelessly to support teachers with training and technical support. She sacrifices lunchtime prep and spends hours before and after school to make sure the teachers are supported. Angie O'Toole from CTA Freedom. Angie goes out of her way to do things for others. She prints the entire school's progress reports quarterly, fixes any oversights and report cards as needed, and fills any request asked. She recently volunteered to do the dunk tank for the Freedom Fest fundraiser when no one else is willing to do it. She continually steps up and wears many hats and fills many slots. Linda Pardo, CTA Goodman Campus. Linda has taken on the task as the new administrative assistant. She's willing to drop whatever important task she's doing to help someone, whether anything really, whether it's finding the lost megaphone, answering the never-ending phone calls, greeting parents as they walk in the door, or guiding kids toward the nurse. Linda always has a smile on her face and a calming demeanor that is contagious. Next is Sherry Clapp from CTA Humphrey. Sherry began her teaching career 29 years ago when Humphrey Elementary School opened in 1986. During these years, she has touched the lives of thousands of students and families, many of whom she have come back to visit her each year. While Sherry has contributed so much as a teacher, she's also worked a wonderful, has been a wonderful colleague and friend. The staff at CTA would like to congratulate Sherry on her 29 years of successful teaching experience and to thank her for all she continues to do. Becky Babcock from CTA Independence. Becky's a sixth grade teacher and she switched grade levels this year when asked by administration. She serves as team lead to help strengthen the grade and guiding a team of great teachers. She has demonstrated initiative by bringing the 7 habits of highly effective students to her grade level, as well as spearheading the implementation of the National Honor Society at the school. Becky is also a Spalding trainer and coach. We appreciate all you do. Michelle Wittmeyer from CTA Liberty is next. Michelle's classroom environment is supportive, encouraging, and standards-based. She understands and implements essential elements of instruction and constantly works toward improving student academic ability while helping them understand the material. Her passion for teaching is not only commendable, but she can be sensed in her teaching and an incessant motivation for her students. Heather Grant, Elite Performance Academy, is next. Heather plays an integral role in developing the positive and upbeat spirit of Elite Performance Academy. Heather understands all the different intricacies of starting a new school and has always lent more than just a helping hand with all this needed to be done. The students and staff has benefited from her creativity and colorful personality with everything that she does at the school. Noemi Navarrete from Frey Elementary is next. Excitement for teaching, enthusiasm for learning, and discovery are some words used to describe Noemi. She is hardworking and tireless and prepares for teaching her third grade class. She approaches any and all challenges with a positive attitude. Noemi is a joy to work with, and she looks for students' strengths and introduces the curriculum in a way that will catch their attention and encourage them to learn and succeed. April Lucas from Fulton Elementary. Beginning of the school year, April warmly greets her first grade students and creates a warm and caring climate in her classroom where students are eager to learn each and every day. Students are engaged in their learning and well-planned group activities, and April encourages her first graders to work collaboratively on a regular basis. April exhibits the highest qualities of professionalism, both her demeanor, and consistently strives to grow professionally. Melody Cordes from Galveston Elementary, preschool paraprofessional and crossing guard. She's truly vested in the students, the school, and the Galveston community. It's amazing to see all she does, both in and out of the classroom, work as a crosswalk attendant, pre-K aide, and after-school club leader, as well as Chandler sports team leader. Boy, does she just do it all at Galveston Elementary. Kim Abramson from Haley Elementary, music teacher. Kim always greets everyone with a cheerful smile, and her students are so excited to go to music class. Even the younger students get to play an instrument. She does a fabulous job organizing the Veterans Day Assembly. It really gives chills and brings tears to those who watch it every single year. Not to mention drama club, choir club, and third grade performance she does each and every year. Aaron Walker from Hancock Elementary. Erin is a true leader, and she brings a positive attitude to all situations and looks for innovative ways to solve problems. Erin eagerly supports her teammates in daily activities and in times of crisis. She seeks creative ways to engage students in learning and freely shares ideas with her teammates. Carrie Kester, math specialist at Hartford Sylvie Encinas. Carrie took on the responsibility of Galileo and Star Math training, as well as her math specialist duties after a staff member transferred. She strives to help the staff understand the data and create assessments using the new technology. She has trained the support staff on the new programs so they can assist teachers as well. Debbie Chamberlain from Hull Elementary, second grade teacher. Debbie is dedicated and determined to give her students the very best education. She puts in long hours both at school and when she gets home at coming home with new and rigorous lessons for the second grade students. She's been known to be up doing research for ideas at 3 a.m. The positive energy and love she brings to her job every day is contagious. Michelle Kovac from Jacobson Elementary, school assistant. As school assistant, Michelle is the first person to greet most parents, staff, and students as they enter the office. She has a passion for customer service and a giant heart. Jacobson feels like a real community in large part because she knows the names of so many of the students and their parents. She's friendly, outgoing, patient, and juggles multiple tasks without missing a beat. Justin Durham, PE teacher from Knox Gifted Academy. Justin is not only the PE teacher, he's so much more. He's truly committed to the health and success of the children. A few of the extra projects that he takes on are intramurals for the students during lunch, Fit Club in the morning, staff versus student games, fundraising events, creating schedules for the gift of time, just to name a few. And Justin also creates the school special schedules. He's truly a talent at Knox. Cassie Itzel from Navarette Elementary. Second grade teacher. For the past 2 years, she's taken the huge task of single-handedly designing and putting together the school yearbook. Cassie is also the school's infinite campus representative. She fields many, many questions from staff members and always takes her own time to assist and explain. Appreciate all you do, Cassie. Laura Alvar from Patterson Elementary, third grade teacher. Laura has the gift of looking at every situation with humor. Absolutely nothing gets her down. No matter what is thrown in her direction, she handles it with charm and a smile. There are many educators deserving the recognition awards, doing untold good and service for students and staff, but Laura certainly stands out, even among the elite group of staff at Patterson. Incredible example for her peers. Rafe Yard from Riggs Elementary, the admin assistant. Whenever anyone needs help with anything, it is Rafe that is always there to provide an answer. She always has a positive attitude and always knows what to do. Rafe is very organized and wears the hat of many people. Without Rafe, Riggs would not be the school that it is today. One of the things that we all appreciate most about Rafe is her willingness to figure things out. Yvette Steen from Ryan Elementary. Yvette also wears many hats, and too many to really accurately list, but some of them include case manager, testing coordinator, special education team leader, intervention teacher, duty teacher, and her primary roles as student council services specialist and special education team leader at Ryan Elementary. She truly excels. Next is Mindy Johnson from Sanborn Elementary. Mindy is active with the student council. She's a fearless team leader, participates in the school social friendship committee, and is dedicated to take on the ROTC coordinator for Sanborn. The amazing thing about Mindy is that she never complains. She does everything with 100% effort all of the time. Debbie Vickman from San Marcos Elementary. Debbie is the reading specialist, and it's a woman who does anything for any teacher, para, or student on campus. She's an amazing reading specialist working with students and teachers to ensure each student has the best opportunity to learn. She also runs the after-school sports league and was a huge success thanks to the innumerable hours she put in. She's on the A-plus committee this year, acts as fourth grade lead, runs intercession school, sets up classroom reading volunteers, you name it, Debbie does it. Next is Kelly Sade from Santan Elementary. Physical education teacher, a passionate educator since 2010 here, and values excellence and personal best when working with her kids. She goes above and beyond for students and makes her PE classes engaging, challenging, and fun. Kelly serves in various capacities on site, such as the running club, student council, Olvais anti-bullying program, and the field day. Next, from Shumway Leadership Academy, Patty Chinchilla, Title I coordinator. Patty's integral to the Parent Communication Action Team and recently took the lead in facilitating Shumway's Leader in Me Parent Nights, which presented in both English and Spanish. She maintains high standards of professionalism in everything she does while making everyone she comes in contact feel valued. Next is Vanessa Bergen from Tarwater Elementary. Student Service Coordinator, Vanessa has a sincere dedication and passion for special needs children. She's an advocate for all children, and she works with them being their voice, providing care, and always looking out for their well-being. She's a hardworking individual who is always able to deal with difficult situations and a level head, providing guidance for staff, parents, and students. Next are the junior high schools from Anderson Junior High. Chris James, social studies teacher. And while this is only Chris's third year teaching, he already has demonstrated skills of a master teacher. In addition to being a great teacher, Chris coaches football and wrestling at Anderson Junior and is co-sponsor for student council. As a project for his administration master's class, Chris took on the task of resurrecting the Anderson Junior High School PTO. Vogel Junior High's Linda Redding, science teacher. Linda seeks opportunity to not only improve the culture of her classroom, but also for everyone on campus. She's a source of inspiration for all staff at Bogle. Through sponsorship with the Bogle Cares Club, she helps kids see that they can have an impact on their lives of others through community service and involvement. Ryan Cussey from Payne Junior High School, 8th grade social studies teacher. Ryan is a valuable asset to Payne as a teacher, colleague, coach, and club sponsor. He inspires his students to learn, his professionalism is unrelenting, and he's a wealth of knowledge and motivates the teachers around him through his positive outlook on life. Ryan is an amazing resource and always has time for whomever walks through his door. As a coach, he's influenced a true team spirit and personal best for all of his players. Jill Swaniner from Santan Junior High, 8th grade language arts. Jill's fun, calm demeanor makes her a pleasure to be around. She holds herself to high standards and is professional in doing so. With her sweet creative flair, Jill facilitates camaraderie between her colleagues by organizing book clubs, taking on extra tasks for her department, and offering great input when analyzing data and planning to meet the needs of students. Willis Junior High School's Garrett Foster, paraprofessional. Now, Garrett works in the Willis Edge classroom as a paraprofessional assigned to work with a specific student. This can be an extremely challenging job requiring a caring attitude and a great deal of patience. Garrett always has a smile on his face and demonstrates an inspirational sense of humor when dealing with difficult situations. Thank you, Garrett. From Arizona College Prep Erie campus, Larissa Thompson, teacher. Larissa focuses on the whole student, not solely the academic piece. She makes learning an interactive, hands-on experience in the classroom. Students do not passively learn about science, but they experience on a daily basis in her brightly colored classroom. Larissa truly cares about her students and goes above and beyond to make sure they are receiving a quality science experience. From Arizona College Prep Oakland campus, Teresa Wines, language arts. Now, Teresa's a relatively new addition to the ACP Oakland staff, yet her impact on campus is profound. From her very first day, Teresa has made the school a better place. She brings a wealth of knowledge and experience in teaching language arts, and she's a leader not only in her department, but among the entire staff. She has proven to be a student favorite as well. Amy Fonte, security guard at Basha Accelerated Middle School. Amy is a keystone at Basha High School's Accelerated Middle School. She greets every student with a smile and cheerful greeting at drop-off every day. Students know she's there, constantly the person that will keep them safe at school, help them at lunch, and cheer them up if they're just having a bad day. Thank you, Amy. Patrick Kim, head custodian at Chief Learning Academy. Patrick has helped keep Hills Academy clean school running at 8 consecutive years. He consistently builds positive relationships with students and connects well with them. Patrick is a great team member and a great asset to Chief Hill Learning Academy. On to the high schools. Carol Skosipek from Basher High School, the bookstore manager. Carol went from assisting the organization of the Accelerated Middle School to spearheading the school's webpage to now controlling the bookstore monies and new book inventory this year. Carol has such a positive attitude as numerous teachers, administrators, and booster club presidents look to her for guidance and to get answers for their questions. She is a true supporter of Basher High School, and she stays on to help out with extracurricular activities as the go-to person that will help in any way possible. Kelly Strong from Casteel High, Special Education Department Chair. Kelly's been instrumental in establishing a special education department that strives to support teachers and encourage students to be stronger self-advocates. She always is available to talk about best strategies with students and lends a hand when dealing with difficult situations. This semester, she's attended more than 70 meetings with parents, teachers, students, and administrators. Thank you, Kelly. Curtis Hoekstra from Chandler High School, custodian. This is a big campus with about 60 acres, and Curtis is one of the key people to keep it clean. Amazing custodian, always willing to go the extra mile to continue to make Chandler High look pristine. It's a 90-plus year old campus, and it looks like it's brand new most days. He makes it look pristine, and the kids and the staff are really proud of their school because of the work that Curtis and his staff do. No job is too big for Curtis, and he will do anything that anyone ever asks him to do. Nancy Martino, a secretary at Perry High School. Now, it's no secret that in order to stand out, you need to be creative, which by today's excelling standards mean you should constantly search for new solutions and more effective approaches in everything you do. You must also have the ability to perfectly implement delegated tasks and be effective at it. You want to be an exceptional staff member, and you have to act out on their own expectations and an example. Nancy does all of that and more. From our support sites, community education, Patty LaFlamme, site lead at CTA Goodman. Patty is the mentor, site leader for Beyond the Bell. She's run the largest site at CTA Goodman for many years, as well as being a camp manager for multiple summer and intersession camp locations. Patty supports the children and families at CTA Goodman not only during program hours, but after school hours, also reaching to check on children who are ill or families that need some emotional support. Gloria Slade from the district office. Now, Gloria is a member of the purchasing department since 1992, and she's counted on my staff throughout the district just about anything. No matter how busy she is, Gloria is always patient, friendly, and more than willing to help those asking. Her knowledge, experience, and dedication are the qualities that make Gloria such a pleasure to work with. Whether you deal with her directly or not, she can rest assured that somewhere, somehow, Gloria most likely has been involved in the seamless process of providing the district with products and services. From the Melinda Romero Instructional Resource Center, Jamie Merrill. She's an instructional specialist for English Language Learner Program. Her coaching ability is amazing. She has a true, genuine concern for students of a second language, and the knowledge that she so kindly shares with all students, administrators, and students is truly appreciated. She's trained and coached various stages of newly arrived teachers both last year and this year. She's worked tirelessly with the Mandarin Chinese teachers at Tarwater. Jamie's an amazing teacher that loves to share her knowledge. I don't believe Kathy Maroney is here, correct? Okay. Next is Lauren Ailes from the Perry East Transportation Yard. He's our final guest tonight. As a bus driver, Lauren is very pleasant to work with, and he has a very positive attitude towards his kids and his fellow drivers. Lauren steps up with other drivers who need help, and he's willing to help out with routes that need covered. He also is very quick to respond when a request for help goes over the radio. With little advance notice, he will take an assignment and complete the task to the best of his ability. Would you join me in one more round of applause for all of our great staff members? That's going to conclude a nice program. We want to welcome you to stick around in the foyer. We've got cookies and punch. Also, take all the balloons home with you. Come up and take pictures with the governing board and enjoy your night.